field extraction training can be done by an administrator whenever a project has to be trained before operators start working on it. Training by the administrator is also a good idea if the auto-learning machine learning training is not sufficiently addressing the capture problems. To get started with field extraction training, one can maneuver over to the field extraction training batches. We've already got one field extraction training batch. The other way to get there is click View, Open Field Extraction Training Batches, and we can create a batch. And when we create a batch, we're going to be given a dialog where we want to select up which vendor to associate this training batch with. And in this case, we want Sola Sea Hotel. Once that batch is created, I can load images. And I will select three of these four images, and they get recognized. Technically, you can add just a single image to a training batch, but we recommend at least three. I think numbers up to 10 and 14 aren't a bad idea, depending on the complexity of the invoice. What's interesting and really cool about automatic training is that the software will assess how many images need to be put in the training batch automatically, and it will lock the training batch when it feels like it's hit a spot where no additional images are needed. And an administrator can always go in and delete images or add images to a training batch, unlocking and locking the batches needed manually. Now the administrator can go into each document and specify the data that's missing. So you can see the challenge for this particular invoice, finding the correct date, the arrived date, or the departed date. Actually, that's the date of invoicing. So that's the correct date. I'll go ahead and select it for that document. And also for the second document. And finally, that's incorrect there. I'll make a correction there. And I'll save my changes. And now I can specify which documents are used for training and which are used for testing. So now it becomes more evident why a larger batch could be helpful. But I can right click here and set the document state to for testing. And so when we train the batch, these two images will be used to create the training algorithm, to create that adjunctive layout, and this document can be used for testing the results of that adjunctive layout. And now I can select my images and click train, and the training is completed successfully. And know that an additional flexi layout, some call it a flexi layout variant, it's determined by comparing the recognition results from the previous version of the flexi layout. And so a decision can be made whether or not to keep the changes. If the quality of the new flexi layout variant is worse than the quality of the old flexi layout variant, or the quality of the main layout plus any additional flexi layouts, the new flexi layout is discarded and a user sees a corresponding message. So we can see which of the documents in the training batch were actually used. We can also see that this training batch has been locked. As mentioned previously, once this training is complete, we can actually export the trained flexi layout, take a look at it, if needed, make changes to it, and then re-import the flexi layout. So let's switch from the field extraction training batch to a working batch and load up images, and we'll see what our recognition results look like. And we're just going to focus right now on the invoice date, and we see that the invoice date was correctly located on each of the documents. And note again that we're performing normalization here. So that was a successful administrator-based training activity.